Welcome students for today's class. Today we are going to see the go back and sender, how it is going to work out. Last class we have seen about the RDT, all the versions of RDT, that is nothing but your reliable data transfer. How you are going to transfer the data from one place to another place. Okay, regarding that we have seen it in the last class. So now what we are going to do? Now we are going to see how we are going to use this go back and sender. Okay, so now as the first point you can see the sender window of up to n consecutive transmitted but unacknowledged packets. So it means that first we are going to check about the sender side. So in your sender side, what will happen? You will be having n number of data packets. So what you are going to do? That n number of data packets you have to keep in the name of your sequence number. Then you are going to transmit all these consecutive data packets to the receiver side. So how it will be happening? You can see this is a diagram, and in this diagram you can see all the colored numbers are there. Through the colored numbers you can understand what is the meaning of that. The first part, whatever is there, that is nothing but your green color. That is already acknowledged. Okay. So this green color packets, whatever you are seeing, that is your already acknowledged packets. So the yellow color packets, those who are there waiting to send it to the receiver side, that is nothing but your not yet acknowledged, because it is waiting in the pipeline that it needs to be acknowledged. What is the next one? That is blue color. You can see the packets which all are in the blue color, that packets has not been sent yet. And the like normal black and white color packets, you can see that packets has not been utilized till now. Okay, so it means that the packets bearing the color from the green to the yellow, they are already in the send. You are going to send it. That is in one sequence. So the next sequence number will be from the blue, which has not been sent yet. So now what is your window size? There will be some window size here. We have given the window size from here to here. Let it to be n for the timing. When we will see in the example, you can understand how you are going to give the window size. Now what is happening here? You can see it has been blurred also. That is your window size. You have to calculate some cumulative acknowledgement. Cumulative acknowledgement in the sense acknowledgement of the n packets. So the number of packets we are going to send are n packets. So we should receive n acknowledgement. As n number of packets we are sending, so we should receive the n acknowledgement. Why it is like that? Because n number, how many numbers of packets you are sending? If you are not receiving that many numbers of packet acknowledgement, it means that your packet somehow, somewhere it has been lost. So what you are going to do? That you should get that many number of acknowledgement, and that is nothing but known as your cumulative acknowledgement. An acknowledgement for all the packets up to including sequence n. It means that as n number of packets we have taken, so n number of acknowledgement also we will get. What we are going to do is we will number all of them as your n sequence number. Okay, we are going to give the number as n sequence number. So what will happen in this way? Whenever in the receiving side, whenever they will receive all the packets, they will move the window forward to begin at n plus 1. Okay, first sequence will be there, then next sequence will be there. They will move to the n plus 1. How it is working out, we will see in the next slide. The timer for the oldest in flight packets, in flight packets, what is the meaning of this line? It means that whenever we will transmit any kind of the packets, we have to give the timeline. So within that time period, it has to receive in your receiver side, and the acknowledgement also has to reach in your sender side. If it is not reaching within that time period, it means that the packet has been lost. So what you are going to do in that time? it will show you that the time out of the number, which number of packet has been time out, it will show you that packet number here. And you are going to retransmit the packet with the sequence number packets in the window. You are going to retransmit the same packet whatever has been lost. Now, here you can see what is happening in the same time in the receiver. So here you can see acknowledgement only. The receiver will send only the acknowledgement correctly. So it will always send the acknowledgement for correctly received packet. Whenever it will receive the packet, suppose packet 0 has been received in your receiver end. So acknowledgement 0 has to be sent to your sender side. Then what will happen? Everything will be in your in order sequence number. Okay, everything will be in your in order. It will not try to disturb the order also. Then what is the next point? It may generate the duplicate acknowledgement. So it may generate, because suppose the acknowledgement has not been reached inside your resender side. That time what you are going to do? You have to retransmit your acknowledgement. So that time it may happen that the sender can receive the duplicate acknowledgement. So that time what to do? We have to see that also. And also one more thing, it need only remember receive base. What is the meaning of that? It has to need only the receive base. There will be a base. Okay. I will show you in the diagram also how that receive base. Whenever you are writing the program, you have to use this keyword. On receipt of out of order packet, because I told you in before, whenever we are going to receive the packets and whenever we are sending the acknowledgement, everything will be in order. So if suppose the packet has not been reached and it became the out of order, that time what you're going to do, you can discard or buffer it. Okay, so these things has to be done in your implementation part. It can be discarded, the packet can be discarded, or if you want, you can keep it in your buffer. That can be taken care in your implementation part. Then what is going to be happen? You are going to re-acknowledge the packet with the highest in order. Wherever the packet will get lost, that from that onwards, again you have to make as in order sequence and you are going to send the packets. You can see here the diagram. The receiver view is there, and in this receiver view, there will be sequence number of space. There will be some of the packets. Okay. So what is the color here? The green color, what it is saying? It has been already received and already acknowledged. So no problem till your green color packets. No problem in that. That has been already received and also it has been acknowledged. So here one packet has been, this is a receive base. We will see what is that. This gray color means this packet has not been received. That's the reason this packet is going to save inside your RCB underscore base. This is a variable name where this packet is going to be saved. Okay. Next, what is the packet? As this packet is not been reached, the next onwards, all the packets cannot be, it will be received, but cannot be acknowledged, because the order, it was in order. Due to this gray color packet, everything became out of order. That's the reason we cannot acknowledge the next packets. So this pink color packets, whatever you are seeing, this packet has been received in your receiver side, but the receiver is unable to name the packets. So now how we are going to solve these issues, we will see in the next slide. Here you can see how the go back in will be in the action, how it is going to be working out. Let's take, this is my sender side, this is my receiver side. Here the sender side has set the window size as your n equals to 4. So it means that at a time only 4 packets it is able to send from your sender to receiver side. So now let's consider this. You can see I have 8 number of packets. As it has been started from 0, there will be 9 packets. Okay. So my window size is n equals to 4. As n equals to 4, so the packet of 0, 1, 2, 3 will be in sequence. Okay, this is my first sequence. So whenever we will send the packets at a time, all these 0, 1, 2, 3 packets we are going to send it. So I have sent packet 0, packet 1, packet 2, packet 3. I have sent all first sequence, all my 4 packets, and I am just waiting in the sender side. That time, the same time, what is happening in your receiver side? Receiver side, it has been received the packet 0 and sent the acknowledgement 0 successfully. Then next one, packet 1 also it has been received and sent the acknowledgement 1. But the packet 2 has been lost in somewhere. So what it is going to do? From here to here, it will just wait. Okay, the receiver end, it will just wait. But still, it has not got the packets. What it will do? By the time, packet 3 also sent, right? So the packet 3 has been received, okay? But it has been discarded. Why it is? Because the receiver was unable to send the packet 2 acknowledgement. As it is unable to send, as the packet has not been reached, it was not in order sequence. That's the reason it has been discarded. Now next, what happened? Within that same time period, it is going to this green color mark, whatever you are seeing, it is going to send all the acknowledgement. Here you can see in the sender side, receive acknowledgement 0. Okay. So whenever it will receive the acknowledgement 0, it means that it is the time to send the next sequence. So as the window size is n equals to 4, the next sequence has to be 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we should send the next sequence number. But what is happening? As only acknowledgement 0 we received, it means that we came to know 0 has been successfully received. So next sequence, it has to calculate from here itself. 1, 2, 3, 4. Why it is so? Because the sender is not knowing till now that which packet has been received or which packet has been lost. If it has been received properly, then it could have been sent the next sequence number, that is 4, 5, 6, 7. But he doesn't know, the sender side doesn't know that which packet has been received. So now next, what is happening? Whenever the acknowledgement 1 has been received, it will come to know that yes, my 1 also successfully received. Now my window will just move to the next one. What is that? 2, 3, 4, 5. Then here only, as 4 packet has been sent, here 5th packet will send. So after 4, 5, 6, 7, it will give a pause and it will just wait like the previous sequence. So now what is happening? It is sending in this way. But what is happening in the same time in the receiver side? As the packet 2 has not been received and the packet 3 already has been discarded, similar process, the packet 4 also discarded, the packet 5 also discarded. Okay. So now you can see here what it is happening. Here, whenever it has been packet 3 has been discarded, what it has done is, as the current acknowledgement 1 has been sent, it will resend again in the packet 3 time also, because it has not received the packet 2. Similar thing also, it will happen in your packet 4 also. It will resend the acknowledgement 1 once again. Similarly, again it will happen in the packet 5. So if it will send in multiple times, in sender side what will happen? It will have some duplicate acknowledgement. Now what we have to do? We have to ignore all this duplicate acknowledgement. You can see now. Now next, what is happening? It has been received the packet 4 and packet 5. So here you can see it has been half only. Why it is so? Half only, it has not been reached. Why it is so? The packet 2, whatever has been lost, so we have given some milliseconds of time period for each of the packet. So that milliseconds of time period has got over here only. You can see here only it got over. So what will happen here? As the timeout packet, time out over, so it means that it came to know that packet 2 has lost somewhere, because we are not receiving the acknowledgement 2. Continuously, we are receiving the acknowledgement 1. Then what will happen? again the sequence, the window, it will just move. So where? So it will understand that we have to send the packet to once again. So as the window size is n equals to 4, it will consider the next 4 packets, that is 2, 3, 4, 5. It will send continuously all the packets. Then it is going to receive. So once it will receive packet 2, it will deliver, it will send acknowledgement 2. Then again packet 3 within the time period, if it will receive, it will send the acknowledgement 3. Similar process, it will send till acknowledgement 5. Once that is done, it will just, the window will just move towards your 6, 7, 8. Because after that, we don't have any packets. So in this way, your go back n will be in action. And what is the meaning of this? You can see, first you are making it to go, then again it is coming back. So that's the reason the terminology has been used, go back for n number of packets. Moving, this is all about your go back n. Moving towards one more term technology, that is selective repeat. Okay, this is also an important one. You will get the question like the difference between go back n and the selective repeat. This is also a very interesting topic. You can see here what is happening. Selective repeat. The receiver individually acknowledges all correctly received packets. Whenever the receiver will receive all the packets, it will individually acknowledge the packets, correct packets. Then what it is going to do? If suppose any packets has not been received, so the next packet, if it has been received, it will keep all that packets inside the buffer. Okay, why it will keep? To make it as your in order delivery to the upper layer. But what was happening in go back? It was just discarding. But here it will keep inside the buffer. Now, what is the next point? The sender times out or retransmit the individual for unacknowledged packets. If something happens, the sender was delaying in sending the packets, or suppose a packet lost and it has to retransmit once again, that time what it is going to do? It has to maintain the timer for all the, for each of the unacknowledged packet. How it is doing, we will see in the diagram. Next one is sender window, the n consecutive sequence numbers. As we know, in our sender window side, the similar thing, what was happened in your go back n, it is also having the n number of packets, which has to be followed by your sequence number. And there will be some limitations of your sequence number. Okay, whenever you are sending, it should be have some sequence number. Like whenever you are going to send the packets, and also you should have the idea that how many unacknowledged packets are there. So now this is a diagram of your sender and receiver window. As I told you, if the packets will be in the gray color, black and white, it means that till now it has not been used. So next term, if it is in the yellow color, it has been sent, but it has not been acknowledged. And if it is in the green color, it means it has been sent also successfully and it has been acknowledged also. And if it is in the blue color, it means that it has been already used, but it is going to be used, but we have not sent yet. This color code I have given, there is no specific color codes. So whenever you are going to write in your exam, you can just give it as a some barcode, or you can name it. Suppose you can keep it as just you give it fully like black color, you are going to use a black color pen. And suppose here if you want to give, you just give horizontal line or vertical line or some slanting lines. In that way, 4 varieties you make it, and you just try to segregate your sequence number like packets. So here, this is your sender view of your sequence number. So what is happening here? You can see these packets are expected but not yet received in your receiver side. Okay, this is a receiver view. That was a sender view. Whenever the packets were sending, this is a sender view. So this is a receiver view. So in your receiver view, these packets has not been received yet. But what is this one? If it is in the gray color also, you can see that this packet here, it has been not sent and not acknowledged also. But as it is not acknowledged, it has to be inside your receipt base. I told you, if any packets has been sent but not acknowledged, so for the timing, you can keep it in the receipt base. As it is not in the in order, so that's the reason these packets, the pink color packets, everything will be in your out of order. As it will be in out of order, so next what you are going to do? It has to be, but in the selective repeat, let it to be out of order also. We can keep, we cannot discard the packets. We can keep it in our buffer and we can acknowledge them also. Then what will happen? And we can reutilize in the afterwards to make all our acknowledgement in order process. So next, what you're going to do? All these blue color, whatever you are seeing, all these things are inside the sequence also and all are going to acceptable. Now we will see how the sender side it is going to work and how in the receiver side it is going to work. So now you can see here the sender side, the data from the above. So if how you are going to get the data from the above, if the next available sequence number in the window or it is going to send the packets. So what will happen? Always your sequence number will be waiting. Once the previous sequence number sequences has been reached inside your receiver side and got acknowledged, then your next available sequence number in the window, you can send it. But till the time, you need to wait to get over for your previous sequence number. And what is the meaning of this time out of N? If there will be number of packets and if you have sent the packets but it has not been reached inside your receiver end, then you are going to resend the packet and you have to restart the timer. So that is about your time out concept. What about your acknowledgement of N? So you need to get all the acknowledgement for N number of packets. So how you are going to send? How you are going to write in a programmatic way? You have to write the send base, whatever the base you have declared, that and also plus N, the number of packets you are going to add. You have to mark the packet, how many packets has been received. And also, if N will be very smallest one, which one is not which has not been acknowledged, what you are going to do? You can keep it in your window base, which is going to be in known as your unacknowledged sequence. If any packet is not lost or something is not acknowledged, you can make one more sequence. You can create one more sequence in your selective repeat and you can name it as your unacknowledged sequence number. What is happening in your receiver side? Similarly, as here acknowledgement N, send base plus N, here it also should be there because as N packets are sending, N packets also has to be received. So here you have to write receive base, comma, receive base plus N minus 1. Why 1? Because we are starting from N number of packets. Okay. So it has to be N minus 1. And you are going to send all these things to your acknowledgement N. So here your acknowledgement N. So you are going to send all the acknowledgement to all the all the number of packets. If it will be out of order, you need to keep it inside your buffer. And if it is in order, you need to deliver with your acknowledgement number. And also what is happening here, you can see that, And also you can see, suppose advance window to next not yet received packet. What is the meaning of this? Suppose already the packet has been sent, but it is in the next window. Okay. So what you are going to do, it will be kept inside your advanced window size. Then in your packet N will be receive base minus N and also receive base minus 1. Because the packets, whatever we are receiving, if suppose any packet will get lost, not acknowledged, we have to keep in this. This is a programmatic way. Otherwise, what you are going to do? You are going to ignore it. Now let's see how it is going to work out the selective repeat. in action. Here my window size will be n equals to 4. This is my sender side, this is my receiver side. So I have my same number of packets, whatever I have taken the same example in my go back n. Here I have to send all these packets. I have sent packet 0, 1, 2, 3. So what happened? Receive the packet 0, send the acknowledgement 0. Receive the packet 1, send the acknowledgement 1. But what happened here? The packet 2 got lost. But packet 3 sent and also received. So what is happening? As it is not in order, this packet 3 will be inside your buffer with this acknowledgement 3. Next, what it is going to do? It has to send the acknowledgement. So here, the receive the acknowledgement 0. As it has been received successfully, my window, my sequences will get turned. So it will be now towards your 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to send my next packet, that is 4. I have sent. As the packet 2 has not received, this one also will be inside your buffer. Next packet 5 also will go in the similar way and it will also be in the buffer with the assigned acknowledgement. Next, what you are going to do? It will just record that acknowledgement 3 has been arrived, where as it is in the buffer, it will send the message that it has been already arrived. And here we came to know that the packet 2 time allotted, whatever given, it has been already over. Now, next, what you're going to do? You have to send the packet 2 once again. Once you have sent the packet 2, but you are not going to send the 3, 4, 5 because it is already in the buffer. No need to send again. So once you will send the packet 2, it is going to receive the packet 2 and it will deliver the packet 2, 3, 4, 5 because everything was in the buffer in order. So it is going to send. Once the acknowledgement 2 also will get received, simultaneously it will receive all the rest of the acknowledgement also. So now you can see here, this is a selective repeat, the example how it is going to work out. You can see in the sender side and this is your receiver side. If my here I have given the example as, these all are my sequence numbers. My base will be 4 countings I have kept. And here you can see the window size is 3. So I have to send at a time 3 packets. I have sent 0, 1, 2. So what happened? So in this side, 0 has been received. So my window got moved to 1, 2, 3. Now 1 has been received. My window got moved to 2, 3. Then what is happening? Again 0 is there. So 2, 3, 0. Now packet 2 also has been received. Now it has been received, moved towards 301. It is going to send it. So what is happening here? The packet 3 got lost. Okay. So what it is going to do? It will send the again. So it has to, the sequence number has to be wait. But in this case, there will be no problem because one window has already done. So you are going to send it through your one more window. But here what is happening? Because here you are receiving, but here you are not receiving the acknowledgement. So if you are not receiving the acknowledgement and the timeout over, you are going to retransmit all the packets once again till you will get or receive the acknowledgement in order process. So next, what you are going to do, you can see that this is a problematic thing. Here you are receiving the acknowledgement, but here you are not receiving the acknowledgement. That is a problem thing. So now you can see here how it is working out in your receiver side. The receiver, here it is receiving, it is sending also to the sender side. Here also receiving, here also you are sending to the receiver side. But here some mistake happened and the packet has the, like acknowledgement has not been received. That's the reason this is a problematic. So what you are going to do, how you are going to avoid this problem here? So you need to keep everything in the buffer so that all the packets will be safe in while sending the acknowledgement towards the sender side. It has to be safe. So this is all about your go back in and selective repeat.